Hi everyone, my name is Vivek and welcome to my YouTube channel. This is the 9th episode to create a static website using Bootstrap 4. In the previous episode, we worked on client testimonials. And today, we'll be working on this pricing and plans. First of all, let's create a new section after this testimonial block. Then let's add the container fluid div. I want to call it pricing block, and I also want to add another class called pricing block as well. Then let's add new div with a class called title holder, and we have to add the S2 tag so that we can add the heading inside it. Then under this subtitle div, let's add the subheading. Now refresh the site and you should see the pricing and plan heading. Then let's add this content using the Bootstrap grid. So just after the title holder, you can create a div with a class called row, and then another div with a class called goal SM4. Then we will split each column into 3 divs. The first one will be div with a class called heading. The second one will be the content div, and the third one will be the button holder div. So let's create them. Content is the second div, and then button holder is the third div. Then I will write this basic title under this S3 tag, and for the price I will create a new span with a class called price, and then add the price over here like this. Then for this list item, let's open the Bootstrap site, go to documentation and components. Then click on list group, and I'm gonna use this ULLI. So copy that HTML code and paste it over here. Then one by one you can copy and paste it over here. Then for the button holder, again you can go back to your Bootstrap website, click on buttons, and then we can use this link button. So copy that anchor tag and paste it over here. Then you can simply change the button text into order now. Now let's refresh the site, and you should see exactly the same content as in our design. Now I will pause my video and add rest of this content. Now I have added all the content based on the first column, so refresh the site again and you should see all the content. Now the only thing we are missing is this popular text and the red background. And for this red background, all you have to do is you have to add a class called highlighted block. Then for the popular text, you have to add another span with a class called ribbon, and then you can simply write your popular text. It is now looking exactly the same as in our design. Great. This is the end of the session. In the next session, we'll work on a blog. Feel free to comment below if you have any questions. Also, please don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel to get more tutorials in the future. Thank you.